Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. This nugget of wisdom will show you the simple steps on how to reset your Mac to factory settings. The assumptions made in this nugget are that you have a basic understanding of the Mac desktop elements. If you don't, I recommend that you click the information link at the top of this screen and watch my nugget of wisdom titled The Mac Desktop before proceeding. At the time of this recording, which is June 2018, this Mac has the latest version of OS X installed, which is 10.13, also known as High Sierra. And the Mac itself is a late 2012 model of the Mac Mini. When it left the Apple production line, I believe it had the Mac OS 10.8 installed, also known as Mountain Lion. So for this demonstration, that's what I want to roll it back to. Then I'll apply the updates via the App Store to get it back to High Sierra. But first, I'll explain the options available and then we'll start the operation. First, I need to reboot my Mac into the recovery mode. This is done by restarting and holding down one of the following key combinations immediately after the initial audible power on chime. The keys to hold down depend on your preference. To install the latest Mac OS, which was previously installed on your Mac, it's Command and R. If you've got an older Mac which won't support the latest operating system, you can upgrade to the latest Mac OS, which is compatible with your Mac, using Option, Command and R. And if you want to install the original Mac OS which came with the Mac, or the closest version which is still available, it's Shift, Option, Command and R. Apple recommends that you use the first option, which is Command and R, if you're selling or giving away the Mac that is using OS X El Capitan or earlier, to ensure that the installation isn't associated with your Apple ID. But as I said, I'm going with option 3, which is to take it back to the factory defaults. So holding down my key combination after the restart, I keep the keys held down until I see the spinning globe. Remember, this requires an internet connection, which connects to the Apple server and will download the necessary files to go on to the next step. If you've got a wireless mouse and keyboard, you'll now be prompted to wake them up. Select your language, and then you'll be taken into the Utilities menu. Now, because the previous version I had installed was a more recent version than the original version, it won't allow me to install until I erase the disk and remove the newer version. So I'll select Disk Utility and then Continue. My disk has two parts to it, separated by this line. The top part is the hard disk which I have available to use as I want, and the part below the line is for these utilities which we are currently using. We're just going to focus on the top section. The 500.11GB is the physical disk I can use, and the Macintosh HD is a portion of that physical disk which I have allocated as my C drive. This is called the partition. If we erase the partition, the C drive will remain the same size. Whereas if we erase the 500.11GB disk, we can then recreate one or more partitions and specify their sizes. For this demonstration, I'm just going to erase the partition. The smaller segment of this diagram is representing the Mac OS Utilities partition, which is unusable. Click on the Macintosh hard disk partition and select the Erase tab. I'll leave the format as Mac OS Extended Journaled and then click Erase. Once it's finished, closing this window will take you back to the main menu. Now click Reinstall a new copy of OS X and then continue. Apple now needs to confirm your eligibility to download the software, which is basically confirming that your computer is a genuine Mac. So click Continue to proceed. Once you've read the terms of the license, click Agree to accept them, and then agree to confirm that you've actually read them. Now select the disk partition and then click Install. This will now download the image. Once downloaded, the Mac will restart, boot from the image and install itself. Again, to save time, I've sped up the video. When the installation has finished, the Mac will automatically restart in 10 seconds, or you can click the restart. You can now configure your Mac. At this point, if you have a wireless mouse and keyboard, you may find that they won't work. Give it a few clicks and a few minutes and they should pair. If not, plug in a wired keyboard and using the tab key, you can move around the screen and use the space as the click. And check the box if you want to enable location services. And for this install, I don't. To install items from the App Store, you will need to have an Apple ID, or you can skip this and do it later. By clicking Agree, you are consenting to be bound by the Apple and third-party terms and conditions. And now the mouse is connected, that should make life easier. Click Continue, and then if you agree, just confirm it. Now I'll create my first user account, Computer Tutor. The full name is the alias or friendly name, so you can have spaces which are automatically omitted for the actual account name, and you'll need to add some text for the password hint. Select your time zone. I'm in London. I'll skip registration for now and then confirm that I want to skip it. And that's it. Now if we open up about this Mac, you can see that it's now OS X version 10.8, and I'll open up software updates, and there's my link to upgrade to High Sierra. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this nugget of wisdom useful. Please subscribe to my channel, and if you have any comments on this nugget or wise suggestions for future nuggets, please put them in the comments section. You can also follow me on Twitter and Facebook.